Hi, I'm Tanner. I'm a member of our management team here at Cognitive FX. Today we're going to be asking a couple of questions of Kaydee, our nurse concussion specialist, about hydration and how that can help with your headaches. Kaydee, tell me, what can hydration have to do with headache?
Hydration and headaches, you know, they go hand in hand. Your brain needs fluid just like it needs oxygen. You know, your brain needs those nutrients. It also needs the fluid. And having that correct amount of fluid in your brain is just cohesive. When your brain is having a headache, you know, it can be a signal saying, hey, I need some help here. I need something. And one quick fix is just to drink some water. And maybe it could be that.
So talk to me about what I should be drinking. So I hate drinking water. Can I drink soda, coffee, those kinds of things? Does that count or not really?
Not really, because actually soda, coffee can actually dehydrate you even more. So it kind of, you know, defeats the purpose.
Gotcha.
Water is essential. It's essential for life. We need to have it. Our cells need it. Our joints need it. We even see that some spines have what we call desiccation, and they're lacking a little bit of water. So even just increasing some fluid helps with that. So we can see how even our brain would need it as well. But you know, if you're one of those that has a hard time drinking water, I found that even adding like a cucumber or maybe some fruit in your water to kind of give it that extra flavor makes you want to drink it more. Most people who drink a lot of water actually prefer their water warm. So if you are one who's not liking a lot drinking a lot of water and you're drinking it really cold, try maybe drinking it warm. You can actually drink a lot more when it's at room temperature.
How can I tell if I'm drinking enough water? I heard some rule somewhere about color of my urine or something weird like that. How do I tell if I'm drinking enough?
Enough water. Well, you can look at your urine or even the smell of it.
Ew.
Sometimes, I know, gross, right? But, you know, sometimes after you go pee and you smell, you're like, my urine smells a little strong today. You're probably not drinking enough water. Also, if it's a lot darker in color, you want it to be kind of a pale yellow in color. So that is one way that you can tell. The other way you can tell is just by how you're feeling. You know, is your skin really, really dry? That can be a reason. Do you feel thirsty? If you feel thirsty, it's actually a late sign that you're dehydrated. So make sure you're not getting to that point where you're already like, oh, I'm parched. I need some water. Be like, oh, let me just have some water because it's right next to me and it's one of my goals.
Gotcha. So is there a time that I should be drinking water? I tend to like drink a lot of water at like one time and then forget to drink water for like 6 hours. Is that okay or is that bad?
You know, it's up to you. Really, however you get your water in, you get your water in. I would start earlier in the morning though, so that, you know, towards the evening time, you can kind of start tapering it down because nobody wants to wake up in the middle of the night to have
like
to use the bathroom.
Seven times, yeah.
Right? So just, you know, try to start earlier in the morning. I would recommend more throughout the day. So it's not just one full fell swoop of water. You know, you might get a bellyache after that, and then you're going to not want to drink any more water. Because anytime we do too much or overeat, it's kind of more of a psychological thing for our brain. It's like, well, I don't want any more. It made me sick last time. So try not to do that. But so nice, even, steady amount throughout the day would be best.
Gotcha.
And then slowing it down, maybe tapering it off around 6 so that you can sleep through the night.
Gotcha. So right now with COVID, we're all wearing masks all the time, and I tend to forget to drink water because I can't just shove a water bottle in my face. What are some good tips on remembering to drink water kind of consistently throughout the day?
I would always just have a jug with you. You know, having it with you, they have those one really cool ones that would give you like some goals. Mm-hmm. And you show like 8 o'clock, yay, you started. 12 o'clock, you're almost there. Good job. You know what I mean? It's kind of fun to have that because it gives you some guidance. Those are really great. But also even you can set an alarm on your phone and be like, okay, every hour I'm going to drink some water. And doing that is so helpful for your brain because say you're a workaholic and you've been sitting at your desk for a really long time and your brain probably needs the break anyways. So you're kind of really helping your brain in two ways. One, you're giving it some water, but you're also giving it that break that it needs to step away from the desk, close your eyes for a minute, drink some water, take a few deep breaths, refresh, and then you will realize how much better your work will be that next hour. So taking those breaks every hour, 50 minutes in between work can be really helpful too.
Perfect. Any other thoughts about water?
Yeah, you know, water is just one of those important things. You know, everybody harps on it. You go to the doctors, they ask you if you're drinking water. You go to the gym and they're making sure that you're having the fluids. You know, it's there for a reason though. It's very important that we're having that water, where we're hydrating ourselves. But think about it too, in the winter, we tend to decrease the amount of water we drink just because we feel like, hey, I'm not sweating as much, or it's not as hot. So you tend to stop drinking as much water, but you still need to drink that water. You know, even as we're breathing and in those masks, we're evaporating all that water that we even have just in our lungs. So make sure that even in the winter, you're still keeping up with your water practices.
Okay, Kaydee, thanks for chatting with us today. We'll all go drink a large glass of water.
Okay. It was so fun. Thanks for having me.
For sure. If you'd like to read a little bit more about water and about why it's important for your brain, we'll put a link to the blog post about water from our site in the description below. And be sure to like and subscribe to get more tips on how to help those headaches and those concussion symptoms to feel a little bit better for you.
For more in-depth information on the topic we discussed today, please click on the link in the description below.